What is good, guys? We're here with Blunder vs. Star for Smoke and Snake Draft Phase 2. Looking at the teams real quick, I assume that's a ban of Weavile. SD Mega Scizor, Defog, Mew, Rock, Lando, Z Quivadent, not Z Quivadent, but Z Move, a Volcano with Quivadent, obviously. Toxapex with just standard Spidef. We don't know the item yet. If it's not Black Slash, if it's like Shed Shell, Blunder's Volcarona, if it's Z Shattered Psych, it's gonna be a big problem. Like, even if this is Black Slash, then it's still, like, this Volcarona can still just run through the 6th. If it comes in the correct moment, if it gets the correct setup opportunity, Blunder leads with Bulo. He's gonna be forced out into his Celesteela here, because Icicle Crush would just blow the Bulo away. And looking at Blunder's team, it's potential Rocks Mega Tar, which is crazy. I've never seen that in a long time. Potential Scarf Lottie, but doesn't have to be Scarf. Like, both teams don't necessarily need a Scarf, but they have like a bulky backbone. And yeah, the Mantine is obviously gonna be Defog, Scald, Roost, and then Toxic or Haze, probably Toxic. And the Azimov Volcarona, I assume. Which means this Bulu might be like Bandit or something. I'm not sure about the Bulu yet. So yeah, he goes on the South Sea, that takes a good chunk from that. You can just go for a Leech Sheet here, even if Star predicts that. Even if Star predicts him to not go for Heavy Slam and stays in, Leech Sheet still gives you leftovers and Leech Sheet recovery. So Star's most likely gonna switch here, and Leech Sheet just gives Blunder health back. Celesteela is gonna be nice in this game. He has no Leech Sheet immunity, so he can just spam Leech Sheet. And Celesteela helps him with the Scizor, with the Weavile, with the Lando. And like overall, like I said, he can fight off Leech Sheet. Obviously, Mantine also checks Lando. He's just going to be forced into Mantine here to defog the rocks away that are going to go up here. I assume Star is just going to U-turn out and Toxapex here. Potentially threaten this Mantine out with a Toxic on Toxapex. Blunder will have to scout for that. He's going to defog here. And if I'm Blunder here, what do I go to? Either Celesteela scouting for Toxic or Lottie works. Celesteela would obviously scout better for Toxic, but Lottie works fine overall. There's a T-Spike. So Star has a lot of switch-ins to this Lottie. So I can see Star staying in, predicting Blunder to double. Because like, he has these three potential switches. Weavile obviously doesn't want to take a Draco, but Weavile kind of forces Blunder to not go for a Psychic Shock or like for a Psychic move overall. But yeah, let me talk a bit about these players, how they have been doing in tours lately. Star is, went like 3-0, oh, Fire Blade by Blunder there. Good God, did he really scout for Toxic, or did he just double into Celesteela predicting like Weavile or Scizor to come out? I think he just predicted Weavile or Scizor to come out, or Mew as well, just to get lefties on this. I don't think he specifically really scouted for Toxic. But yeah, Leech Sheet gets off the Leech Sheet, doesn't get burnt, and now he gets the Bulu in. The reason why he went Bulu is to get T-Spiked, is so he can keep switching this into Scald now, and he cannot get burned anymore. And yeah, Star has sees that he has a Mantine in the bag, and he might be tempted to double into either Toxapex or Weavile here. To like, Weavile will potentially threaten the Mantine with a Bandit knockoff. So if Blunder predicts the double here, he would be in a really good spot, as Blunder predicts the double and he's in a fire position now. Gets rid of Weavile. That was one of the main threats to Mantine. Looking like Mantine boards almost the entire squad now. He just has to be careful that he doesn't get toxic on Mantine. And yeah, what I was trying to say is Star went 3-0 in Snake Phase 1. And he won a Smoke 2 the other day in Auras, if I recall correctly. And Blunder went 1-1 in Snake Phase 1. But whatchamacallit, he got hexed a bit in the game versus Finch that he lost. And for Game 3, I think he subbed himself out because he's busy. Well, he told his manager to sub him out. This Pex showed Toxic, T-Spikes. I think it also showed Scald, right? And the last move is also Recover, so it cannot touch the Bulu. So maybe Star thinks that this is a Scarf or Bandit Bulu, because his Pex cannot really touch the Bulu. So I assume Blunder's... He goes in the T-Tail, okay. I thought he would just go into Lottie there, to be honest, but yeah, it works. Getting this poisoned as well means that it cannot get burned. And yeah, the aggressive terrain helps him a bit. The Sandstorm also gets some chip on the Toxapex. Tita gets up Rox. They're really interesting, Rox Megatar. He's gonna switch here into Steela or Mantine. Blunder's gonna be forced to defog soon, even though these two are already poisoned. His main Wincon, the Volk, needs T-Spikes up to set up a Covidence later on the Mew or on the Scizor, and then blow this away with Shattered Psych if he has that move. Blunder's gonna not stay in because he doesn't want to get burned on his Steela, even though he already stayed in on Skull once. He would prefer to not get burned on Steela, obviously. So yeah, the Scizor is quite obvious here, so let's see if Blunder predicts the Scizor. Doubles into Mantine, anticipating the Scizor. Now he can get up the Defog. But yeah, T-Spikes are gonna go up in the long run anyway, because T-Spike have more PP than Defog. But he can still play well, and potentially like go hard into Volcarona later on the turn where the Pex goes for T-Spikes, and get it in before it gets poisoned, and then he can threaten it with Shattered Psych. We do see he only gets Grassy Terrain, so this doesn't have Black Sludge to Toxapex. So it's either like we have seen Z-Haste the other day, or it could be Shed Shell for Heatran. But yeah, his team is quite annoyed by Heatran, not gonna lie. Unless there's Earthquake Mew, his team seems somewhat annoyed by Heatran, so Shed Shell could be an option. It could also be some resist berry, yeah, even though we have never really seen that too much. So he gets up a T-Spike there. Really risky play on Blunder's part. If he went for Toxic there, Mantine would have gone Toxic. Mantine, like I said, walls pretty much the entire team. So I feel like Blunder knew that Star wouldn't go for Toxic. The search was too obvious. Oh my fucking god, how does he know? How does he do it? He stays in on a turn that he doesn't go for Toxic. Then he goes in the Steela on the Toxic, and he goes back on the Mantine on his call. I feel like that was, yes, it was well played by Blunder, but it was also a bit unnecessarily risky. But yeah, Bulu can either just fire off a Horn Leech, or Blunder can double back into Mantine and either defog or fire off a Scald. Most likely gonna if he doubles back to Mantine, he's gonna fire off a Scald because he wants to try and burn his Toxic Pex. Because if the Pex is burned and it doesn't have Black Sludge, which we already know, then it might get put into range from Shattered Psych guaranteed, which is what Blunder wants later for his Volcarona. Because if he comes in with Volcarona, he doesn't want to go for Covidence maybe, because then this can go for Toxic. He just wants to kill it with Shattered Psych or force it out. So for that, it has to be in range. So Blunder would prefer this being burnt, I'm pretty sure. Mm-hmm. So Blunder might, like I said, make the double into Mantine again, predicting the Scizor. Scizor's pretty obvious here. Since the pack set is already revealed. But that's quite interesting, a Megatar on a team like this with... What would the other moves be? I'm pretty sure it's not DD Megatar, because it sure rocks. So he makes the double into Mantine, and he can Scald Fish for a burn here. Do you guys think it's Pursuit Megatar, or... not sure yet. Ghost House Steela on a Toxic. I mean, this is a fine play, because even if this gets burned, it's not the end of the world, but... I feel like you should always go into... I mean, I understand it, because now the terrain ends, and now you can go into Bulu, and then the terrain restarts, but the terrain was still up, so like going Bulu the turn before was fine as well, in my opinion. Yeah, was still a fine play, like... This game, this burn would be a bit annoying for Blunder, but since burn got nerfed, it would still be okay for him. Let's see if he gets burned here. I thought he would go back to Bulu, but he didn't, okay. But yeah, now he can go to Bulu. Even as Leech Seed to get even more health back and counteract the poison damage that he has to take. And Bulu. He could even go to Tita here. Because if the pack stays in, it would get chipped from sand. He leeches again, that was a fire play. Good lord, how does Blunder do it? Star doubles out, knows that Mantine has to come out there because Volcarona is a threat. I mean, Tita could come out as well, but it's more likely for Mantine to come out because Tita still takes a lot from Bug Buzz, and Tita is also poisoned. He keeps going steel on this. Keeps getting it correct. Good god, how did he do it? Yeah, I would probably go into like Bulu or Lari. He goes Lari. There's the Scald, so he can potentially get burned here, as he does get burned, which is fine. Since burn got nerfed, already talked about this. I talk about this a lot. Ooh, Fireplay, knowing Sisoth most likely gonna come out, and now he can Scald again, because I don't think the Pex is burned yet, and he still wants to try to get the burn on the Pex. As he doesn't get it, and he can, since the Weavile is dead, Ladi's actually freed up for Blunder, like, otherwise, he couldn't go freely into Weavile all the time. Not sure why he risks getting the Celesteela burned, though, when the Ladi's already burned, and this is already poisoned. Like, I know this... Like I've talked about it, it's not the end of the world for him if this gets burned, but like it would still be annoying. So I feel like he should... I guess it was a mid-ground play in case Star predicted the Ladi or the Bull to come out and wanted to double into Scizor. But even if Star goes into Scizor, like, Blunder can just switch out after, like, he doesn't have to predict it, I feel. So yeah, the Scizor is once again pretty obvious here. And I don't think he has Hidden Power Fire, because if he has Hidden Power Fire, I feel like he would have gone for it. He keeps making this double to Mantine. He obviously wants the default here. Or, like, yeah, he can Scald again, but since there are two T-Spikes up, you can kind of afford the default. Because, like, if, let's say if Star would use two T-Spikes and he defogs, that would mean he would actually have... Okay, he keeps trying to get the burn. That works out for Blunder. He gets the burn finally. But I was just trying to say, if he uses up two T-Spikes for one defog, then Blunder can keep T-Spikes off. But Star would obviously play it smart in the long run and not always use two T-Spikes before Blunder defogs. Oh my god, Blunder is so fire. Like, you could say he was so fire, but that was risky as well. He just defogged there. And he went Landorus. Not 100% sure what he predicted that turn, but yeah, he can go for a Scald here. God, he risked his Mantine a few times, like two times I think he stayed in on a Pex or something like that. I would never risk it again. Like, Blunder is playing like fire, but I feel like he made like some aggro plays that he didn't have to make. Obviously, the one play put him in a really great position where he caught the Weavile. But after he caught the Weavile already, there were like some other unnecessary risky plays where he could have potentially gotten the Mantine toxic. That would have been really bad for him. There's the Megatar. So, does he just want to chip this with Sandstorm and burn? He's gonna get up his rocks here, I assume, but he's gonna be defogging anyway. Like, since Star is gonna get up his own rocks here, Blunder's forced to defog. Yeah, the T-Spike as well. Like, even if there's only a T-Spike, Blunder's forced to defog eventually as well, like I said, because, Volcarona can win the game. Did I say Tita? Volcarona doesn't, Tita is already poisoned, and Bullet's already poisoned, but just Volk alone that can win the game is worth it to, yeah, exactly, this is what I was talking about earlier. If he gets it in, like, Volk alone is worth it to keep T-Spikes off. He goes for Shattered Psyche, I assume, and this would have been in range to die, but, oh my, what the fuck, it's Payapa? Says Payapa Berry Toxic Spike. Star knew he would, either Star knew he would bring a Volcarona, or, oh my god, Blunder with a Fire Play, that Buck Buzz on the Switch, and watch him go for Psychic, here, predicting the pivot back. Star's team, to be fair, is, like, quite weak to, it's quite weak to Volcarona. So, like, if Toxapex is your main Volcarona measure, it makes sense to have a berry like that, even though we have never really seen that. Like, we have a lot of teams, I've talked about it a few times before, a lot of teams that have Pex as their Volk check just get 6-0 by Volk if the Volk has Shattered Psych, if it comes in on the right in the right moment, on the right mon. So it makes sense, actually, that he has that. Smoke just shed Blunder getting snaked, yeah, I don't know. Not necessarily. But yeah, it sucks a bit for Blunder. He could at least he could weaken the Mew a lot in the process, but a nice prediction on the Bug Buzz on the Switch. I feel like Star might pivot back here. Or he can go for Recover. I think Psychic might not even kill. He seems to be released by Dev on his Toxapex. Which makes sense looking at Star's team, because Ashgrin is a mon that exists, and Ashgrin is a threat to his team. He goes back in the Mew. Blunder goes for Bug Buzz again. Good god. So I guess Psychic might have been a roll. So Blunder at least got something out of these turns where his Volcarona got chipped down and he used up his Z-move. He got at least rid of the Mew with some nice Bug Buzz predictions. Yeah, Blunder playing on this on fire. If this wasn't Payapa, the game was over pretty much. Whenever Vol came in later on Scizor or Mew, then he could have set up again. And yeah, like, Star didn't even have a good Volk measure if his packs went down. Like, he had to go to his own Volk and, like, I don't know. Then he had, like, Equivalence War or, like, a Fire Blast War, I don't know. Like, what else would he have to check Volk after Weavile went down? And, like, Weavile only checks it if it doesn't have a Quiver, obviously. So he lets his Volk go down to... Oh my fucking god, Blunder's fire. So he lets his Volk go down to go to Tita to get up the sand. And he catches Star on the pursuit. Pretty sure Star was feeling like a Stone Edge or Earthquake or something like that that would have killed him. And Blunder with the Fire Pursuit play. And yeah, now Blunder Celesteela looking like it can just win the game because it... Celesteela plus Mantine looking like it wins the game for Blunder is what I'm trying to say. Because Celesteela walls the Lando and the Scizor and beats them with Flamethrower and Leech Seed. I think this is a Helmet Lando, it could also be Yanshi, but I assume it's Helmet. And you can just go Mantine or Steela here on the Scizor. Mantine is a good play here because he goes Bulu, that's odd. Maybe you didn't want to take too much damage on Mantine on the U-turn in case the Volk has HP Electric. You really have to think about everything that Star could have at this point because you're in such a good position if you blunder and you don't want to give it away. Like, you don't want to throw this game away. So I understand it, I guess. How healthy is the Mantine? Because if the Mantine is quite low, then I understand that he didn't go to it on a U-turn because then he would have gotten chipped more and more. What I like about that play is that he didn't go into Celesteela because if you go Celesteela on the U-turn then this can set up potentially and if it has HP Electric and it crewers up and it crits your Mantine or something, he can still lose. Like, you have to think about everything. Like, HP Electric is not common, but we have seen it like a few days ago in Tour. But it was paired, I think, with Coco and Electric Terrain. I think you have to pair with Coco Electric Terrain to do more to Mantine. But yeah, Blunder can go for Toxic here. Because this Volk is like the biggest threat left to his team, and if Star switches out, like, that's fine for Blunder. If he goes Scizor, that's just a free Ruth slash Scald. If he goes Lando, that gets poisoned, so like, you don't lose anything from Toxicing here. Neutral Volcarona doesn't really threaten the Mantine at the moment, so he doesn't have to Ruth yet. It's looking really good for Blunder. This game is quite interesting. Some fire plays from Blunder. Like, there were two or three plays that were, like, I said it already, like, I wouldn't have made them, they were unnecessary risky. But I'm not Blunder, the two gods, so, like, props to him for making them, they worked out, so I cannot say anything. I guess Star has to, like, kind of bank on the Toxic miss and try to Equivalence up at this point. Equivalence is up. There's the Toxic and it connects. So Blunder can go for Roost here. And I assume Star is gonna Quiver again. So even if Star goes for, if he has Shattered Psych, I don't think he has HP Electric. If he has HP Electric, he can still do a lot of damage to Blunder. He has Shattered Psych and there's nothing. Blunder probably Roost again. Yep, great play. I mean, it was unlikely on this team, like I said, he doesn't have a Coco, so it was most likely not HP Electric Volk. That's the only reason why you would run HP Electric. But like, you gotta consider everything if you're Blunder in this scenario, like I said, because you don't want to throw the game away. And yeah, he goes to, okay, sacks off his Tita, so the Volk dies to Poison and Sandstorm. And now Celesteela just wins the game. It's a good game, this was fire, the game, not gonna lie. Like, there were a few, like, Hexy games lately. This game wasn't really Hexy, right? It was a really interesting game with Godlord. So yeah, this is a free Leech Seed after the Flamethrower there. Like, you don't want to go for Heavy Slam and take Helmet, you're also at minus 1. Like, he can either spam Flamethrower or he can spam Leech Seed. He can click Leech Seed here, not spam, just click it once. And yeah, after Landorus goes down, he just clicks Flamethrower twice. Like, two carries the Scizor. Scizor can't do any damage to Celesteela. So, Star has to hope that Blunder DCs, I guess, at this point, or that Blunder, like, misclicks every turn. And let the Scizor, if they let the Scizor go to plus 6 and never clicks Flamethrower, only clicks Heavy Slam, then he can potentially lose, but he's not gonna do that, obviously. Yeah, he doesn't click Heavy Slam ever, because he doesn't want to take potential Helmet damage. And yeah, the lander goes down to Lee's seat here. Scissor comes out now, and he can just click flamethrower and pick up the win. So a little fire game. Thank you guys for watching, and for the people that are that want to see the old T series, they're gonna be coming next hours slash next days. I still gotta make some thumbnails. I gotta re-narrate over one game that I didn't catch live. For one game, I only caught half the game live, and the rest is the replay. And yeah, Snake games, more Snake games are gonna be coming. Stay tuned for that. Have a fantastic day. Hope you all enjoyed, and peace out.